Yes, students, good morning. We are going to do problem number 12 of page number 96. You need to pay attention because this sum is going to be based on invoice price, which we have discussed in the last class. Okay, open page number 96, problem number 12. I'm reading the problem, kindly pay attention. Okay, Warangal, Charan of Warangal consigned 250 cases of Ayurvedic medicine to Ramu of Hyderabad. So Charan is going to be consigner, whereas Ramu is going to be consignee. The cost of each case is rupees 300, but the invoice price is rupees 400 per case. See, here we know that cost price is how much? 300. But Charan doesn't want to reveal how much profit he is making. So intentionally he is saying that ki price is not 300, price is going to be 400. So there is a difference of rupees 100 behind one case. Okay. Charan paid rupees 250 towards packing and carriage. Ramu informed that account sales that 200 cases are sold at 425 each. Expenses paid by the Ramu were freight 600, commission to be calculated at 5% on sale, prepare consignment account and consignee account in the books of Charan. Okay. See, here I am writing in the books of Charan. Okay. In the books of Charan, we are going to prepare three accounts. Pay attention here, guys. Consignment account, debit, credit, particulars, amount, particulars and amount. Okay. Now we are going to prepare what's his name, to whom we are sending? Ramu. Ramu's account. Here I am writing consignee particulars, amount, particulars and amount. And third one will be GSOC account. See students, in this working notes plays a very major role. We are going to do very slowly, but you need to understand this sum very well. If you are not getting, please watch this video again and again. Okay. Here I am preparing working note. Okay. Please dhyan do main kya keh rahi hoon. What are they saying is, Charan of Warangal consigned 250 of cases of Ayurvedic medicines to Ramu of Hyderabad. So here I am writing consignment account debit to GSOC account. First step, 250 cases. Okay. But see, here when it comes on considering prices, we are having two price. Cost of each price is rupees 300, but the invoice price is rupees 400. See, understand this students. 250 into 400. This is going to be our invoice price, right? So how much actually we are saying? 1 lakh rupees. But 250 into 300 is a cost price. Understand? Okay. See, whenever it comes on recording, we will always record invoice price. Okay. What is the invoice price? Invoice price is rupees 400. So how much it is? 1 lakh. Okay. To GSOC. So here I will write by consignment account 1 lakh. See, whenever they are giving us two prices, invoice price and cost price, which price we are going to consider? Invoice price. Okay. But working note mein dekho students, we have considered invoice price and cost price. What is the invoice price? 1 lakh. What is the cost price? 75,000. What is the difference amount? Difference amount is 25,000. So how are we going to record this 25,000? Understand, 2 GSOC 1 lakh hai. So here to record this difference, I am writing here by GSOC account 25,000. Understand, okay? मैंने ये जो भी invoice price और cost price का difference amount है वो मैंने by GSOC 25,000. We have not done this before, okay? So see, here again by GSOC है, so here I will write to consignment account 25,000. Which price we are recording? Invoice price. Now students, next is, what are they saying is, Charan paid rupees 250 towards packing and carriage. So here I will write Charan. So here I will write to cash account in bracket expenses. How much it is? He has spent 250. Are we preparing cash account? No, the simultaneous effect will not appear. Next is, Ramu informed through account sales that 200 cases were sold at rupees 425 each. So here I will write by Ramu's account in bracket sales. How much? 200 into 425. So we need to write down the amount. He is selling for 85,000. 200 into 425. Okay, here again by Ramu. So in Ramu's account, I will write to consignment account 85,000. Okay, next, what are they saying is, see, expenses paid by Ramu were freight 600. So here I am writing Ramu's account expenses 600 to Ramu. So here I will write by consignment account 600. Okay, now next, what are they saying is, commission has to be calculated 5% on sales. So here I will be writing calculation of commission. Calculation of commission. Okay, rate how much? 5%. Am I right? Yes, 5% on sales. Okay, what is a sale? 85,000 into 5% means 5 by 100. This 20, this 20s will get cancelled. 5 zeros are 0, 5 fives are 25, 2 will carry, 8 fives are 40 plus 2, 4,250 is going to be our commission. So here I am writing again to Ramu's account in bracket commission 4,250 to Ramu. So in Ramu's account, I will be writing by consignment account 4,250. Okay. Apart from it, do we have anything else? No. Okay. Now students, what do we need to see over here? Okay. We have sent 250 cases to Ramu. But out of 250, he sold only 200 cases, right? So there is unsold stock, okay? So our next working note will be valuation of unsold stock, okay? See, unsold stock ka jo bhi value aata hai, wo hamesha hum log credit side pe hi record karte hai. Right? See, but now, here, अनसोल्ड स्टॉक कितना है? अनसोल्ड स्टॉक इज इक्वल टू 50 केसेस. एम आई राइट? 50 केसेस आर अनसोल्ड. ओके, नाउ हियर आई विल बी राइटिंग कॉस्ट ऑफ अनसोल्ड केसेस. सी, बट व्हेन इट कम्स ऑन कॉस्ट ऑफ अनसोल्ड केसेस, पहले के सम्स में वी यूज टू हैव ओनली वन प्राइस, राइट? कॉस्ट प्राइस यूज टू बी ओनली वन, बट हियर नाउ वी आर हैविंग टू प्राइसेस, राइट? सो हियर आई एम राइटिंग वन IP एंड वन CP, दैट इज अ कॉस्ट प्राइस. IP कितना है? IP इज अ 400. CP कितना है? CP इज 300 वन केस, राइट? सो हियर आई विल बी राइटिंग कॉस्ट ऑफ अनसोल्ड केसेस. ओके, सो 400 इंटू 50, 20,000. 50 इंटू 300 विल बी 15,000. ओके, कॉस्ट ऑफ अनसोल्ड केसेस, व्हाट वी डिड, सी, सोल्ड 50 केसेस, राइट? तो व्हाट डिड आई डू ओवर हियर? 50 इंटू 400, 50 इंटू 300, ऐड प्रपोर्शनेट एक्सपेंसेस ऑफ कंसाइनर. वी आर गोइंग टू कंसिडर ऑल एक्सपेंसेस ऑफ कंसाइनर. कंसाइनर एक्सपेंसेस आर 250, ओके, बट वी वॉन्ट ओनली फॉर 50. हाउ मेनी टोटल केसेस वी सेंट? 250. सो answer will be 50. These expenses are going to be same when it comes on IP and CP. Okay, then here add proportionate expenses, proportionate direct expenses of कंसाइनी. ओके, डायरेक्ट एक्सपेंसेस मीन्स फ्राइट, कैरेज, कार्टेज. तो हियर सी स्टूडेंट, 600 दे हैव स्पेंट फॉर फ्राइट, सो 600 आर गोइंग टू बी अवर डायरेक्ट एक्सपेंसेस. बट 600 ही हैज स्पेंट फॉर 250 केसेस, वी वॉन्ट ओनली फॉर 50. ओके, सो सी स्टूडेंट्स, दिस जीरो विल गेट कैंसिल. 5 1 5 5 5 5 25. नाउ अगेन 5 1 5 5 2 10, 0 will be as it is. So proportional expenses will be 120. Okay, now value of unsold stock. Okay, here I will do 20,170. Okay, 20,170. And here it will be 15,170. Okay, we are having two things, students. Okay, here pay attention. Value of unsold stock. According to invoice price, it is 20,170. Value of unsold stock according to CP, that is a cost price, is 15,170. Okay, for us IP is important. We know that unsold stock we will always record it at credit side. By unsold stock, IP amount we will consider how much? 20,170. But see students, if you are going to pay attention here, you will find that there is a difference. That difference is known as stock reserve. Okay, what is the amount of that stock reserve? 5,000. Difference between IP and CP is 5,000. How are we going to record this? Unsold stock ke opposite, here I will write to stock reserve. How much? 5,000. That's it. We are done with the sum. Okay, now let's do the rough work. First, let's find out in consignment whether we are getting a profit or loss. First we'll do the total of credit side. So credit side 0, then 7, then your 1, then 5 plus 5, 10. 1 will carry 8, 2 plus 8, 10, 10 plus 2, 12 plus 1, 13. Debit side total we will do now. First I'll write 0, then we are having 5, 5 plus 5, 10. 1 will carry 2 plus 1, 3, 6 plus 3, 9, 9 plus 2, 11. 1 will carry 4 plus 1, 5, 5, 5, 10. 1 will carry, 1 will write as it is, that 1 lakh 1 is going to be as it is. See students, my credit side total is 1,30,170 and my debit side total is 1,10,100. So my income is more than my expense. 1,30,170, I will write both the sides. Okay, so here I am getting a profit balancing figure. What is the profit amount I am getting here? 07003 - 12. 20,070 rupees is my profit. Okay, now let's see here. Balance carry forward 85,000 minus 4,850. Okay, so you will get amount 80,150. Okay, 80,150. And here to trading account balance we need to transfer 1 lakh minus 25,000, 75,000 we are going to transfer to trading account. Okay, see, this was problem number 12. What is the difference in this problem is, in this problem they have given you invoice price and cost price. The first change will be over here, that is whenever you are sending goods, okay, first you need to prepare working note. You have to consider invoice price as well and cost price as well, okay? But when it comes on recording, first you will record to GSOC according to your invoice price, okay? Then you will give a simultaneous effect, okay? Then you will find out the difference between invoice price and cost price. Whatever amount you will get, that you need to record by passing another entry. By GSOC, simultaneous effect to consignment. Other things are going to be constant. Whatever we have used to do in the previous sum, same thing we are going to do here as well. Again, where the difficulty will come? Whenever there is an unsold stock, okay? So when it comes on valuation of unsold stock, because you are having two prices, invoice price and cost price, you just need to consider that. Here also what we did, 50 into 400, 300 into 50. Other things were similar, okay? When it comes on recording, first you should be knowing that unsold stock will always come at credit side. But which amount we are going to record? Invoice price. Cost price we are not recording anywhere. We are just writing the difference between invoice price and cost price by passing opposite entry, that is a stock reserve. And then we are going to do the balancing stuff which we used to do in previous sums as well. This was problem number 12. If you are having doubts, please do ask. Thank you.